Today, I want to talk to you about a relationship between what is called alternating current and direct current, usually called AC and DC in the electrical world. And the difference is that the DC that's shown in the red line here is the average value. Think of this as potential or voltage. Think of this as time. So when things vary as a function of time, you notice that the red line is a constant, but the blue line is changing. So when we look at information in an electrical signal, the information is always contained in the thing that is going up and down. If the potential was always constant, that carries no information for us, right? So if you want to convey information using electrical signals, then they do have to go up and down. Broadly speaking, there are two kinds. One is called analog, the other is called digital. If it's analog, it would vary like what I've shown. It can be anything. If it's digital, it's basically changing between two values. But whether it is digital or analog, the fact of the matter is, if I want to convey information or carry information from point A to point B using electrical signals, then there has to be variation as a function of time, right? Now, if I look at the average value of that, so if you look at this blue signal, if you ask me what is its average value, I would say it is what this red line is shown. That's the average value. So the alternating part, the AC part, is going up and down with respect to the DC part, which is the average value, right? So we can say that the AC is superimposed on top of the DC. So I can keep the signal the same, but the DC value can go up and down. For example, it may be around zero. If it's around zero, this whole thing will shift down, which means that the signal as it goes up and down, part of the time it's going to be positive, part of the time it's going to be negative, but the important thing is the information is the same because the shape of this blue line or the AC part does not change, right? So the question is, what is the importance of the DC value in this signal? If the information is all contained in the AC part, then the question is, does the average part matter? Does it mean anything? Well, it turns out that the power contained in that signal is not only a function of the AC part, but the DC part also. Because the potential is high with respect to zero, which means that it has a lot of power in that thing if you combine the DC part and the AC part. Now the question is, how does that compare with, say, my life, right? So let's move over here and let's look at how I transport that information or that theory into my world, is what I've called it, right? So the fact is, in all of our lives, things go up and down, right? That's part of life. I don't think things can be steady all the time. As a matter of fact, I would claim that if it is steady all the time, nothing ever changes in life. Not only is it a very boring life that contains no meaning in life either. So for a life to be meaningful, things have to go up and down. That's part of life, right? But the question is, if you look at this axis here, I would claim that what I'm calling the zero axis here, let us look at this. Suppose this is how my life is, right? Part of the time things are going positive, part of the time things are going negative. The question is, how do I deal with this? Because if it goes positive, I may get excited, I may be happy. If it goes negative, I may still get excited, but in a negative way, and I may be miserable, right? So the question is, can things still go up and down in life, right? And yet, I'm never sad, and I'm always happy and in a good frame of mind, even as things are going up and down. The answer to that is yes, of course. You have to increase the average value, so to speak, right? So if you look at this dotted line here, this is supposed to be same as this, right? So if you look at this dotted line, it is the same events in my life going up and down. Nothing changes except if I have constant knowledge and that knowledge as to why things go up and down in life, then that constant knowledge will elevate every event that happens in your life to a much higher level. What is happening is exactly the same thing. Externally, nobody knows that there's a difference, right? You see this all the time. You know, there are some people, even while they're going through difficult times, they're very happy, you know, they're unmoved. And there are some people, even when things are going up, they're very sad. Why is that? That's because of the knowledge. So if you have correct knowledge, then you get a positive upliftment of the signal, so to speak, in your life, the events that go up and down, which actually carries the meaning in your life. On the other hand, let us say that I have incorrect knowledge, I'll be taking this whole thing and moving it down. So whether it goes up or it goes down, you're miserable all the time because you have incorrect knowledge about everything. Even when something going up, you'll still be miserable if you don't understand why things go up and down and have a broader knowledge. So my claim is that what we should focus on, oftentimes, you know, we look at life and say, how something is going down, I say, how do I make it go up, right? That's my focus. It's going down, I want to make it go up. Well, that necessarily is not important. What is important is to increase the knowledge base so that you understand the meaning of what is happening in your life as things go up and down, so that whether it's up or down, it will never reach the negative territory, which means that you're never miserable. And that's what I wanted to say today. And I'm calling this AC/DC because it's the relationship between the alternating part of life and the constant part in life. Thank you.